Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Zootopia Movie Review. Before we start, let I introduce our group members. First, we have Fatin Amira binti Muhammad Fauzi. Next, Aina Maisara binti Muhammad Sofi, Muhammad Farizwan bin Nur Azman, Nur Nadira Husna binti Muhammad Latif, and lastly, me, Muhammad Fauzan bin Malik.
I have 36 hours left. We can only solve it together.
It's not about how badly you want something. It's about what you are capable of.
I am a real cop.
Never let them see that they get to you. You bunnies. So emotional.
No, no, no! Do not let go!
I'm gonna let go!
What?
We may be evolved, but deep down, we are still animals.
Quit it! You're gonna start a howl!
Naked.
For sure, we're a naturalist club.
All the way down.
Try everything.
Life's a little bit messy. Try everything. We all make mistakes. No matter what type of animal you are, change starts with you.
We gotta go.
Whose car is it?
The most feared crime boss, Mr. Big.
Okay, so firstly, the movie review for Zootopia. The movie is about the city of Zootopia. It's a where numerous animals live from the biggest elephant to the smallest cat. A rabbit named Judy Hopps finds out how difficult it is to uphold the law when she joins the police department as the first rabbit. So Judy has seized the chance to crack a case within 48 hours because she wants to show her ability even though she is a small animal. So Judy Hopps was then forced to meet a fox which named Nightwild to find a solution. In the cases that happened in this movie, is Judy Hopps realized that the missing animals had been located and also discovered a more victim of the cases. So this making a total of 14 victims who are all predatory animals victims.
Now I will explain the two main stakeholders and their stake. The first one is Chief Bogo. He feels that Judy does not deserve the opportunity to become a police officer, and he believes that she is not living up to the standard that he has set for her. For this reason, he wants to get rid of Judy. Next, he also wants the Zootopia Police, ZPD, to be only among those who have a proven worthy of the trust through their deeds and achievement. The next stakeholder is Mayor Leondo Lionheart. He wants to defend the citizens of Zootopia and the city itself, so that is constantly in a condition of safety and harmony. Next, he also wants to make sure that all animals are treated the same way.
Okay, so in this slide, I will explain about the main actor and what is their ethical dilemma. Okay, so the first one is the heroine, which is Judy Hopps. She is a police officer at the Zootopia. Okay, her ethical dilemma is whether she should be helping Mrs. Otterton is searching for the loss of her husband within the 48 hours as Chief Bogo specified, or else she will be fired. Okay, so when Chief Bogo threatened her with her job, she was shocked because that was unexpected of him. However, when Mayor Bellwether gave her the permission to search for Mr. Otterton, she was very happy and delightful. Right after that, she went to search the evidence of the whereabouts of Mr. Otterton with the help of the hero, which is Nightwild. In this case, she chose to help Mrs. Otterton because she believed that is the right thing to do, and it is the duty of the police officer to help those people in need, and not because the pressure of getting fired by Chief Bogo. Okay, so next is the hero, which is Nightwild. At first, he just a normal citizen. However, alongside the movie, he successfully become a partner with Judy as a police officer. Okay, so his ethical dilemma is whether he should be helping Judy in searching for Mr. Otterton or risk getting exposed in paying the high amount of taxes since he never declared his income. Okay, so when Judy was searching the evidence of Mr. Otterton, she found that Mr. Otterton was buying the popsicle that was sold by Nick, and she believed that Nick can help her in finding Mr. Otterton. So in this case, Nick decided to help Judy in searching for Mr. Otterton, and due to their hard work together in finding Mr. Otterton, they successfully found Mr. Otterton and discovered the truth behind the reason why these animals are becoming savage. Okay, so next is the villain, which is the Mayor Bellwether. Her ethical dilemma is whether she should hurt Judy or spare her life and risk getting exposed to the public of her wrongdoings. Okay, so this is because in this movie, Mayor Bellwether has taken a liking to Judy because she believed that Judy and her belong to the same category. However, when Judy was searching the truth behind the Night Hollow, which is the reason this animal becoming savage, she discovered that Mayor Bellwether is the mastermind behind this agenda. Okay, when Mayor Bellwether find out, she decided to hurt Judy in order to protect her secret. However, because of the great teamwork between Nick and Judy, her plan was failed, and in the moment, Mayor Bellwether was caught in the act, and right after that, the truth is getting exposed to the public to raise awareness among the other animals.
Okay, so firstly, the actions that happened in the movie is when Chief Bogo did not assign Judy Hopps the same duty as the other police officer to locate 14 missing animals or mammals, we can see unequal treatment was shown. This is because we can see that Chief Bogo did assign the case to other police officer who was better able to deal it rather than Judy Hopps, in his opinion. Therefore, by giving Judy Hopps simply a parking duty to summon the automobile instead of a big task to find 14 missing mammal kids, Chief Bogo did not treat her equally to other police officer. We also can see that Chief Bogo has a bias against Judy because despite graduating with high honors, she lacks field experience as a police officer. In addition, Judy is the only bunny in a police district populated by giant animals like rhinos, tigers, hippos, elephants, and also wolves. And she hasn't proven that she can work well with this larger officer. This makes Judy become determined to prove her ability, as she believes that she also can solve the big task even though she have a small body.
Now I will discuss the action taken by the heroine Judy Hopps from a deontology point of view. The ethical philosophy known as deontology states that actions are either good or bad based on a strict compliance with a predetermined list of regulation. Judy Hopps did a first job by suing 200 vehicles that were late paying their parking ticket, even though some of them were only a few seconds late. Judy even sued the police vehicle she was driving herself for a late paying for parking because she thought following the rules was a good ethic. In the other scene also, Judy Hopps also followed the conditions that have been set by Chief Bogo, where she will resign if she cannot solve the case of the disappearance of Mr. Emmett Otterton within 48 hours. She thinks to be a good cop, she has to follow whatever rules have been set by the superior.
Let me recap a little bit of Bellwether. Firstly, she is the former assistant mayor of the city, and she is the hidden man of the antagonist in this movie. I just thought she's just a side character which normally appears in the movie, and her characteristic is just shy, helpful, and genetic overworking. However, it was mind blow, and it is a plot twist which really happened in the Disney movie. So let's start with the question. Cite the feeling of remorse, guilt, shame that you will feel as a villain. Firstly, she is a very cool and power hunger that she will kill anybody who stood in her way or did not share her idea. She will employ all available method to in order to success her plan. For instance, when Judy and Nick find out the truth about the accident, she did not hesitate to kill them. This means that she only cared about the minority and political power, and this is to demonstrate why she should be ashamed of her behavior. Okay, for the next part, where the accident Bellwether show strong bias against the predator, which she think that the predator is strangers and we fail to prey in terms of intelligence, such as she considers the fact that she is a harsh and vengeful person who wants to drive out the predator in out of the city and only make the prey stay in the city only. For example, she invite Judy to team up and to against the predator. In this part, it demonstrates the Bellwether cool selfishness and her essentially lack of concern of anybody but herself only. For example, she really did not want to help her town, not even as assistant mayor or after me become mayor, because she believed that becoming mayor is about earning recognition and achievement. In this show that she really ignore the is her responsibility as the mayor and only focus on the adult aspect. So in this case, she should take the important as the leader, how to become a good leader. So that's all for me.
The golden rule can be described as do unto others as you would have them to do unto you, which means to treat others the way we want them to treat us. If we were in the Bellwether's shoes, we should take advantage of our power and intelligence to make a decision that will benefit others. Great leaders are someone that able to make decisions that benefit themselves, their teams, their stakeholders and their organizations by maintaining a balance between emotion and rationality. In Zootopia, we can see that Bellwether used her intelligence in a wrong way as she manipulates prey to turn against predators by turning every predatory animal savage. She also puts a goal to rule Zootopia with a new order in life where prey dominates predator as she becomes a mayor of Zootopia. Next, we should avoid making assumptions on individuals based on their appearance. In Zootopia, we can see that Bellwether views predators as an unforgivable breed with an unjustified power attitude over prey. During her day as an assistant to Mayor Lionheart, she had been neglected all her assistants repeatedly by Mayor Lionheart, who's a predatory mammal. She eventually grows to hate the predatory mammal species and the way they treated prey species. We should never judge or stereotype a specific group of people or animals, and especially to never jump to conclusions about others just because a certain people treated us in a bad way. Lastly, if we were in Bellwether's shoes, we should practice forgiveness and letting go of the past to handle ego and anger. As Bellwether grows hate toward the predatory mammal species, she formed an alliance with Rams, who shared her ideas and used Nightcrawler flowers to make a chemical drug that might turn civilized mammals savage, because Bellwether has allegedly been mistreated repeatedly by predatory mammals through her existence. Thus, by practicing forgiving and letting go the past, we will be spared from grudge that leads to unethical behavior. Lesson from the movie. We as a society and as individuals can coexist no matter our ethnicity, gender or whether we are herbivore or carnivore. Zootopia reminds us that we can all live peacefully with one another. In Zootopia, you can never be sure of an animal's identity or look, and most people are bigger than they appear to be. This lesson is crucial because we have all been fooled by someone we trusted or have put less faith in someone who is capable of doing good actions.